Morning, Alan.
Hi, morning.
I'm Mark, I'm your physio.
Hi, Mark. How are you?
How are you doing? I'm very good.
I'm good.
Good. Nice to see you. Nice. I'm here today just to have a wee look at how you're moving.
Okay.
If that's okay. Yeah. I'd like to get a sense of your control of your movement, and we're particularly interested today in muscle tone.
Okay.
That's, if you like, the amount of tension or relaxation in your muscles. And how the strokes affected you in that respect.
Okay.
Do you have any pain or injuries or anything I need to know about?
No.
Any operations or whatnot that might affect the way you move?
I've had tendon
transfer, I think you said, and a release, I think you said. Yeah.
Just to release the tendon.
Okay.
Just because to stop the tightness.
So you've had some surgery on this wrist and hand, so we'll bear that in mind. Okay. So first of all, I'd just like to have a wee look at you, if that's okay. So just you relax. I might just put my hands on and help you to move, if that's all right.
Of course.
If you want me to stop at any time, just let me know. Okay. So just observing at the moment, you're looking good there. I can see, and you've shown me that in this arm there's a wee bit more difficulty moving than in the left. You elected to shake hands with your left hand, so this one has been affected by the stroke to some extent.
Yeah, it's probably the worst part. Okay. The stroke has been the arm.
Okay. All right, that's helpful. Thank you. So I'm just going to move around to your left side here. And the reason I'm moving to your left side is I just want to feel what the muscles feel like on the side that the stroke hasn't affected.
Right.
So I'm just thinking about the amount of tension in these muscles. So I'm just feeling how much tone is in them, if you like. And I can establish that by giving them a squeeze, so I can feel these muscles have got some activity there, but not excessive. It's quite soft, and I can move the leg at the hip. Okay, I can lift the leg up. I can feel you following me when I move this leg.
Yeah.
In fact, you've got good control of that leg, and you can move it in space.
Yeah.
Now, that tells me that on this left side in the leg, you can both feel where I'm putting it, but you can also adjust the amount of activity in your muscles as I move it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And if I come up to your left hand here, again, it feels like a very light arm. You're able to move it yourself. And I can put it in anywhere in space.
Yeah.
And you've got control of it. Yeah. That means that you're adjusting the amount of tension in your muscles according to the position it's in space, against the force of gravity. So gravity is trying to drop this arm, drop this leg through the bed. Your muscles are able to counteract that and allow this to move in space nice and smoothly and freely. So that's good. It's also telling me that in this position, you're quite relaxed, which is great. So I'd like to come round and just have a wee comparison on this side, if I may. And again, so if I come to this leg here, it's allowing me to move into medial and lateral rotation at the hip. Okay, so it feels quite low toned, we would say, so there's no resistance to that movement. I'm just going to come in under the heel here and just bend the leg up a little bit. But the difference here is I'm not feeling this leg following me so much. So for example, if I let this leg go, this leg's tending to just fall down to the bed. If I feel the muscles themselves, they're softer than they are on this side. So the muscles here are more relaxed, if you like. So there's less tension. If I look as well, there's more bulk in the muscle on your left than there is on the right. So the strokes cause this muscle to get a bit smaller as well. Okay. If I just check the range of motion here, we feel that we've got a lot of movement into lateral rotation at the hip, a bit tight into medial rotation.
Yeah.
Okay, and that's quite common, so the leg tends to fall out to the side, especially if it's got quite low muscle tone. I just want to compare with the left hip. Again, just very carefully hold here, support you here. Yeah. So it's a bit tighter at the left hip. You feel that?
Yeah.
A bit tighter, so that
it
shouldn't be anything. I think what it's showing is just that this right hip is very relaxed.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. So if I come up to your arm now, bearing in mind what we were able to do with the lesson. We're going to lift this very carefully so that we don't cause any pain. And again, this one doesn't quite follow in the same way. And it's tending to be, could feel quite heavy to move. And tell me if there's any discomfort associated with this.
Oh.
Okay, so that's good range of movement at the shoulder here. Okay, now, are you able to lift this arm in the air? Okay, that's excellent. So what we're seeing here is having to generate a lot of activity on the left side in order to activate the right. And we can see that we're getting quite a bit of extensor activity in the right leg as well. And excellent, have a wee rest. So in this position, the arm is tending to come into abduction and medial rotation as it flexes. So the elbow tends to come away from the side as opposed to up in this position. Before I take the shoulder beyond 90 degrees, I just want to check that we've got a bit of mobility at the scapula here. So if you just relax for me a wee minute, just let everything go. Let me just feel what the shoulder's like here. That feel okay?
Yeah.
And when I'm moving the shoulder here, I'm thinking of keeping the shoulder blade or the scapula and the humerus well aligned, so we're not causing any potential trauma to the glenohumeral joint. That's the shoulder joint. That feel okay?
Yeah.
Okay. And then as we come up into flexion, I just want to make sure that the scapula is following here. So I'm just feeling the spine of the scapula here down to the, that's perfect, thank you, down to the inferior angle, and just make sure the scapula comes up as well. Any pain there?
No.
Excellent. And relax again. Have a wee look at your hand. Have a wee stretch, reach up towards the ceiling. There you go. So we can get up to 90 degrees, combine shoulder flexion with protraction and rotation of the scapula, and then we can just bring the arm gently back. So maintaining the alignment of the shoulder girdle as we bring them up into flexion. Just have a wee look at your hand again there. Perfect. And a wee bit of restricted range of motion there, but not too bad. But as we look at the muscles, we can see here that there's increased flexor activity going on. And I'm just checking here at the pectoralis major and minor. There's a little bit of increased activity there, but you see that most of the increased activity is in biceps and in brachioradialis here at the elbow. And we can see there's a resistance to passive stretch. So his flexors are active. When it comes to relaxing into extension, we can see that there's a resistance to that, and you can see the muscle activity here, which is different to this side where there's more relaxation. So this is typical of an upper motor neuron spasticity, where we've got a clasp knife phenomenon where it feels tighter in the middle range of the motion, and then as we go towards the end of range, that releases. So a clasp knife phenomenon is what it's called. There's no rigidity or tremor associated with this. So this is a classical picture of spasticity. We can confirm this just by palpating the muscles, and we can feel that there's much more activity in these flexors than really there ought to be in this position, because it should be able to relax down just onto the bed. If I come, and bearing in mind this, are you okay there? Bearing in mind the surgery as well, I'll be careful here.
There's a lot of pain that I get in any part.
Okay. How's the sensation on this side when I'm touching it?
A dull, dull. I can feel.
You can feel it, but it's duller than this side.
Yeah.
Is there any pain or burning or tingling or pins and needles?
No.
Again, we can see we've got a restriction in extension at the wrist here. We just get beyond neutral. I don't want to overcome this because we've obviously got some surgical involvement there. We also lack a bit of supination.
Totally.
But again, that's the sort of position it would have been in, and we've released into this sort of position. Again, we can feel that there's a little bit of a tension to extending the fingers, but again, in relation to the surgery, I'm not going to push this too far, but obviously we would be looking to get the hand into a more extended position. If I, because this is what's called velocity dependent, you find that if I stretch slowly, then the muscle releases quite easily. If I stretch quickly, we can see that the muscle catches. So we've got a catch, if you like, in mid-range here. And as we keep extending it, so the muscle generates more activity. So in terms of controlling this muscle tone or releasing it, slow is best. So a nice slow stretch. We can lay our hand on the muscle as well, which actually causes the muscle to relax locally in order to then extend. And then we can extend the wrist and fingers distally as well. So we can block the wrist with the lateral border of the hand, extend the thumb, extend the fingers, and just gradually put the extension on the wrist. Had you not had the surgery, we can work this a little bit further. The alternative is to flex at the elbow, put the extension on the wrist and fingers, and then extend the elbow. So there's a couple of ways to do it. But so whenever people are working with you, Alan, it's probably a good idea to discuss as a team the way we manage this.
Okay.
So the long wrist, the flexors in the forearm, flexors of the fingers, the elbow, the shoulder, are all the areas which can tighten up that we want to try and control. So let's just relax this arm down onto the bed again. That's good. Okay.